Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to do a product I have hit pan on, and I haven't done this since springtime, so I thought it was a good time to do it again. Since last update, I believe I have finished some of the pans, but I have definitely also gotten some new ones that I'm pretty excited to share with you guys. I haven't counted them, but I have a lot of changes, so I'm pretty excited to show you and share my pan porn with you guys. Yeah, it's just always exciting to hit pan on stuff, and my pan porn collection is getting bigger, and hopefully when you see me next time with this kind of video, some of these products may be gone, but maybe there will be new products that I've hit pan on. I really hope so, but let's just get started. The first one is my bronzer. It is my Essence Sun Club Matte Bronzing Powder for lighter skin. I have it on today because I was just really inspired to use it today. I have some massive pan. It is a massive pan overall, but the pan itself, this one, is okay, I think. It's not bad, but I really, really like this bronzer. It is so beautiful, and again, it's for lighter skin, so it has a perfect tone, I think. I don't think you can buy this anymore, though, which makes me sad because it is a good bronzer. A powder I have hit pan on massively, it is my Essence All About Matte Fixing Compact Powder. I don't know if this was the powder you saw last time or not, but I have massive pan on this powder. It is one I use to set my concealer every single day. It is the only thing I have found that really works for me, that sets my concealer in place and doesn't have a white cast or anything. It is a really nice powder and it's really inexpensive, so this is a recommendation overall if you struggle with your concealer. I go through a few of these each year, so this might be my second one this year. A single shadow that I have hit pan on is one from P2. It is The Future Is Mine Eternal Star Mono Eyeshadow. And I have some small pan right there. I worked on this last year, I believe. So yeah, this is just a beautiful shadow and I can't wait to use it again. I really miss that shadow. Let's take this one. This is my W7 Got It Covered Concealer Palette. I have some good pans on this one. I don't know if I had pan on this or if I have even showed you guys last time I made this kind of video, but I have 4 pans on this. I use it every single day. I wear makeup and I love it. These two are correctors for my under eyes. I'm panning this shade at the moment, and these two are perfect shades for my face, where I have acne and stuff like that. This is a beautiful palette and it just does a really, really nice job because it's creamy and it's pigmented and it's just, it does wonders. It really does. Then we have this palette right here. It is my W7 In The City Natural Nudes Eye Color Palette. It is a 6-pan eyeshadow palette, and as you can see, it is kind of empty. I have finished that one. This one I have finished as well. And then I have repressed these 3 colors right here into smaller pans in my C palettes because it was just more convenient. And then I am left with this shadow right here. I have no idea if I want to use it because it is a very dark brown or grayish shade. My smaller C palette right here has one of the shadows that I have repressed, which is this one. I have a white Catrice eyeshadow that I have double pan on, which is exciting. I use this on my brow bone every single time I wear makeup, basically. A Benefit eyeshadow right here. The mixture from my Panda palette, which is 3 shades that are mixed together. My go-to cream blush right now, which comes from my the Bomb Bomb Joey Rockstar palette. These three are Makeup Geek eyeshadows, and this is a deep-parted lipstick that I use as a lipstick and a cream blush. So I haven't used it since I deep-parted it and melted it into this pan, but this is just the easiest way I think I can use that shadow up. No. Lipstick up. So yeah, it is just chilling in here, and I think this is a beautiful smaller palette and easy to do something with. Then I have my Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette. This is a pre-filmed video, so I can show you guys, and hopefully by this time when I upload this there will be more progress. But this is what my Too Faced Chocolate Bar is looking right now, because this is my Panda palette for 2018. I have a lot of pans, some Franken shadows from other shades. The only one I don't have pan on is semi-sweet. Gilded Ganache over here is just non-existent right now in my mind. So hopefully I can finish this off next year, which will be exciting. I have three highlighters that I have pan on. It is my Makeup Revolution Ultra Pro Glow palette. It is looking like this. I forgot to use it this summer, so I haven't used the darker shades, but I have pan on these three lighter ones, and this is beautiful blush topper that I haven't used. Yeah, you can see I've used them all at some point, but these are the three I have pan on. Then we have the Bomb Bomb Joey Rockstar palette, and it is a beautiful palette. It is one of my faves. It has a beautiful mirror, and this is how it is looking like. So I have pan on this shadow up here. It is called Metallica, and then I have finished off the highlighter down here called Disco Disco Solid Gold. It is a Mary Luminizer with another name, basically. So that is the palette that I have used up right here. Then there was two cream blushes down here. This one is Millie that I have departed and am using in here. So my Makeup C palette, the last item I'm going to talk about in this video, it is looking like this. So I have some Benefit blushes over here, the cream blush from the Bomb palette, bronzer right here, which is also an eyeshadow from Manakadar. I have used up the highlighting side, so this is the remaining of that duo. I have some Catrice single shadows here, like the white shadow, but I have pan on this lighter brown right there. I have pan on a Maybelline single eyeshadow right here. I have the remaining of a NYX duo, contour and highlighting duo, and some Benefit shadows down here, and the two remaining shadows that I had depotted and repressed from this palette. This is my C palette, and that is all of my pan porn actually, and I'm pretty excited about it, and hopefully I can have some new pans showing by the next video I do for this in the springtime. I hope you guys liked it. I love showing you what I have pan on. It is so satisfying to hit pan on any product, no matter if it is a bronzer or an eyeshadow or my day-to-day concealer setting powder. I don't mind. I really like hitting pan. It is so exciting and satisfying. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe down below so you don't miss out on any videos. I would love for you to hang out. And until my next video, please take care. Bye.